friend of mine, Sean Donegan. Sean, great to see you, mate.
Thanks for having us back, Tony.
Oh, no bother. It's always good to have you in for the banter. It's warm in here, isn't it?
It is very warm.
Look at the crack frames. Here it goes. Look at that for a shot. Look at that.
That's paranormal.
Have some shot.
That's paranormal.
Did you see what happened there?
I seen what happened there.
It hit the top, right the, yeah. The viewfinder.
We'll have to investigate that.
We'll have to get that investigated. Tell you what, we're going to do a few shout-outs and then we'll get the show on the road, so we'll have the crack with you, right? So, I was talking to today, a big shout-out to Sarah's Stars, Reza, Sarah, and all Graham and all the Gardens and the Collinses there, the Collins Gardens. Especially a big well done to Ella, at Ella E. Call God. And well done, you won your big pageant the other day. Also to a good man himself, Stephen McKevitt, non-Newry man.
Moon Pops.
Razor Moon Pops. Thanks for tuning into the Banter Show. It's always a pleasure. And I know your parents well and your sister. I know great family.
Good people.
And they're at the heart of the community too. So a quick shout out to my main man here. Official Mr. H, Razor Mr. H, and at the only Mrs. H, Razor Mrs. H. So, Joseph E. Sultana, Grimesy Grimes, Razor Grimesy Grimes, Irish TV, thanks for all the retweets. We've also got the Bible Code Sundays, Andy Nolan. Andy, best of luck with your film, Jack Mulligan. Hopefully, I'll get over to see you shortly. Matthew T. Metzler, Razor Matthew, and Corrine Cohn. Big kisses. Give Corrine a big kiss, sir. She's an Irish woman over there in America.
Lovely.
She's got her sons in Breaking Bad, Matthew T.
Happy days.
So they're all good. And she does a lot of sharing. She shares the Banter Show.
Shares
so friends,
the
whoever's been on the Banter Show, try and give it a share there and get your voice out. Steve Collins, VAP, Razor Steve. And a special shout out to John O'Carroll. Razor for your win at the weekend there, John O. Yeah, champ. Razor champ. Fact Films, Tom Begley. Elise Quevedo. Ray Quinward. Razor Ray the singer. Eddie Kidd, OBE. Come Autumn, and the boys at Field Motion, I always have them wrote down there, they sponsored a big event for us at the weekend for Mickey's Day.
Happy days.
It was a brilliant tournament. Mayo Bridge, Seamus Lively and the Mayo Bridge Band, thanks for coming out. Thanks for coming in with your band, it was fantastic, it was flawless. Great support there from everybody that came Razor to Mickey's Day. The weather let us down, but we battled on through it. The weather never beat us, you know the crack, Sean. Ian Sands and the Blues in the Bay. The Shout, the Split Lips, Sean Simmons at Lock Key, Ciarán at Irish Showreels, Noel Razor-Smith, Bestie and Moon up there in London, Justified Prince, Razor, you're a winner, Lexi PR in Malaga and Amy Ray, Big Rogie, you never rang me, you rascal, you. Give us an own ring and we'll organise a Banter Show.
It's good to talk.
Oh, it's good to talk. And there's a man who could talk with his mouth on his hands. He's some crack. Great man. I want to get in contact with you, Rogie. Ray Mysterio and Sexy the Band, Vinnie Jones, Razor Vinnie Jones, Simply Prestige, Carl Frampton, brilliant one at the weekend. You were rattled in the first and the third, we all know that, but like a true champ from this part of the world, you get up and you fought on. You showed what Donegal you had, let's just say it like that, you know. Power Pack XL, Razor Jeremy Reeve, and Fergus Gaddis, Paddy Barnes, Michael Collin, all Belfast Boxers on Facebook, on the Twitter, sorry, I'm a big Twitter man. Jerry Morgan, Razor Jerry, you're just in New York with the James Bay Band after another whistle stop here.
He's doing well.
He's doing very well. We're proud of you, Jerry. Yeah.
Razor Jerry.
I'm telling all the boys, Egan, that there's a special Razor for the James Bay Band. Also to the Hudson Taylor, they're a great band too. Aurora Dawn and Alabama 3. So that'll do for the shout outs for now. Now, I just have to say, Sarah's Stars. Sarah's looking a bit of sponsorship. As her daughter's really good at these beauty pageants,
yes,
you know.
Yes.
She's only a young girl. She's a lovely young girl. She was bullied there for a while, mm-hmm. and she's got over it, you know.
Yes.
And she's a strong young lady. You keep that up there now, Ella. And Sarah, so if anybody's looking to sponsor, if you want to sponsor your company or your logo or something, get in touch with Sarah Stars, at Sarah Stars on Twitter. And believe me, she'll give you a good PR, won't there? Sean.
Tony.
Sorry about all the shout-outs, brother.
Not a problem.
So, quick one then to all the boys from Mickey's Day. Such a day. It turned out fantastic.
Yeah.
Johnny Quinn and Orla Quinn, thanks for the music. Dermot, my man Dermot McQuaid, fair play to you, Dermot. You turned up. Yeah, turned up, but the event was over. But he did turn up.
He turned up.
That's the main thing. He didn't let me down. Razor. So, Sean, what's happening in the world of Sean Donegan?
Sean Donegan is very busy with the projects of Nocturnal Newry.
Nocturnal Newry?
The Wolf Squad.
Oh.
That's a paranormal events company based in Newry. Under Nocturnal Newry, we have the Newry Murder Mystery Club. We have Sean of the Dead Photography.
That's you.
That's myself, Sean of the Dead.
I like that, Sean of the Dead.
Razor for Sean of the Dead.
Razor for the Sean of the Dead Photography.
Yeah, so I basically photograph and document a lot of the historical buildings that would be paranormal investigating, but I would go to these buildings during the day and document the history, because a lot of the buildings around the country, a lot of them are abandoned and decaying and subject to graffiti and...
damp and all the
damp
rest.
Damp, abuse. Decay. So I like to document them, how they are and how they're, you know, progressing. Now, lucky enough, some of the buildings, they are getting looked after. They have thrusts coming in. History is a big thing these days, you know, and, you know, trying to preserve what once was is... it's good for tourism too, you know. So I document all these buildings through photography, and I put it up on Facebook and on the website, the Nocturnal Newry website, www.nocturnalnewry.com.
Check it out.
So that's Sean of the Dead. Nocturnal Newry, as I say, we have a team of paranormal investigators, works for the event company with the parent company Nocturnal Newry. And we run castle trips to Ireland's most haunted castles, Leap Castle, Ross Castle, all these places. We give people who don't necessarily have the access, we give those people a chance to come along with us and enjoy a weekend's crack and investigations. You know, we do bed and breakfast, evening meals, the whole package, paranormal investigation and the social nights. And Leap Castle is renowned as one of the most haunted castles in the world. So we open it up to the general public. Will it be slack people, you know, no riffraffs. You can't be going down, you know, it's not a drinking weekend. It's you can down to meet Sean down in down in Leap Castle. It's just a beautiful surrounding. It's made famous by all the big TV paranormal programmes, Ghost Adventures, Ghost Hunters. They've all done it. Most Haunted have all been at Leap Castle. So we're opening that up to the public. We'll take people down from Newry and beyond, like we people travel from all over going to the events. We also do the old town holiday village, Nomeath.
Yeah, that's a regular spot for you.
That's a regular
spot. Because it's very close.
It's very, very close.
Geographically,
it's very handy. Got to. We do events in it maybe twice a month. Now, in the good weather, we would have sleepovers. People are crazy enough to want to sleep over in it and have an all night investigation.
Does that work?
Well, we have it organised from 8 o'clock till 2 o'clock, where we have a structure of events where you have your induction, the history of the building, the health and safety aspect of everything. Then you have your spiritual protection, protected against anything negative, just to make sure everybody's both spiritually and physically protected. Then we'll have various experiments. We break people up into teams and we carry out and conduct various experiments throughout the night. We have our supper and all. That's very important to get the grub in and keep people warm, fueled with tea and coffee. I give a shout out to Graham Finnegan over there and Grounded.
Razor Graham.
Our first overnight investigation down in the team. Graham sponsored all the hot beverages, so it was a winner. And you'll find that local businesses supporting, you know, one another, which is quite good. We were only getting started off and, you know, we got to help out there. But around 2 o'clock then, that's the schedule events have finished and it's up to you what you want to do then. So what we do is we try and facilitate everybody and what they want to do. Some people have had activity in a certain area and they want a private investigation down there. So I have a big squad of people and we can accommodate that. Some other people want to hear more history of the building. Some people want to sit around the campfire and hear ghost stories, toast marshmallows, have a bit of crack. So we have all those aspects going on. And then some people want to bed down for the night in some of the older haunted rooms. So we do whatever the public want, we'll do for them down there, you know. And it's a building that keeps on giving and giving. I've done about 400 hours of research with the guys and that, and we document everything. We also document that by photo as well, because we have been subject to some vandalism because of the popularity and notoriety of the building's history and what we're doing at Nocturnery. People would rather break in than go on a tour, and so they're damaging the building. But lucky enough, now we're working together, and we have it secure, and we have it very, very usable, and so we're picking up a lot of voices. Everything, photographs, anything we can, it's all documented, it's all filed, so we have research to go back and see, right, we had contact with this person or spirit, his name, like we have some spirits out the minute we found out. We know his name, we know now how he died, when he died, where he's buried, and that's the spirit communicating directly with ourselves, you know.
Wow,
so
I'm impressed.
It's not just about, you know, taking people in. We're not about taking people in and scaring them. What we try to do is a personal paranormal experience where you get in contact with the spirit, maybe physically, you might get touched, but you will, by the end of it, we'll have you tuned in that you'll notice the spirits around you, maybe the negative and the positive spirits, and hopefully we'll catch some voices. And so, like, you could take people down and you could scare the life out of them, and that would be it, you know, but once people get that personal paranormal experience, we find that it's almost like a drug where they come back for more, and they come to different events with us then, you know. When
start getting into it then, really.
Some people really get the bug, you know.
Yeah.
And it's,
well, obviously, you said a point there earlier on that there's no drinking involved.
There's no alcohol. We don't mix spirits with spirits.
Only in the Banter Show, friends.
Only in the Banter.
That was quite
exclusive.
I like that. That was an exclusive. But it does make sense, because you know the air crack, when the couple of drinks and the party atmosphere starts, and then they'll not take it seriously.
Well, there's also the fact that once there's a belief in the paranormal world, and it's all over the shamanic world, when the shamans and the witch doctors and that, and all these tribes, they'll take drugs to get them into the spiritual world. So the belief is, if you went on an investigation and if you were drinking and taking drugs and that, there, that you're opened up more to maybe the possibility of something negative affecting you, you know. So you're as well with no drink or drugs.
So, in other words, if you got drunk, you could upset the spirit world.
You could upset the spirit world, and you could open yourself up for maybe something coming home with you, you know.
That you didn't want to take home with you. You didn't expect.
You might want to be taking a girl home, and you end up with maybe 3 or 4 ghosts in the room with you, you know.
Not a good idea.
Different
not
things going bump in the night, not that you expected.
Now, we had our own investigation just before this
just
video.
Just before this.
I showed you a video that was put up on the Facebook.
Yeah.
DQ's is up on your wall and Bernice's wall.
Yeah.
Somebody sent in from Newry, I think it was Barry Kennedy, the name was.
Yeah.
And he was getting the smell. His dog passed away.
Smell a wet dog, yeah.
Getting the smell and a wet dog in the kitchen. Small orbs. Mm-hmm. And then I showed you the video, what that fella took. And it's quite clear.
Yeah, it's very clear.
The
orbs, especially, when people will dismiss orbs on a photograph, they'll dismiss that as dust. But it was on video. It's seen movement, intelligent movement, and then while you're looking at that, it's unmistakably the dog walking through, and you can see the
even the shape of the dog,
the shape of the dog,
the paws,
and
the head, the back, the tail.
Yeah, that's
it's incredible.
It's an undoubtedly bit of evidence. It's unreputed, like, you know, it's one of the best I've seen of an animal.
You didn't expect that,
did you? I didn't expect that.
So the paranormal, I showed the paranormal man a bit of paranormal dog. So there you go, that's a new one on you.
Smells, especially in the spiritual world as well. When a loved one has passed, sometimes they come back in visitation, so you might smell their perfume or aftershave, and they've come back to show you some comfort because you're grieving them. So quite possibly the dog knows. Dogs are very intelligent animals anyway, and they're very close to their owner. So the people are grieving the dog, and he's come back quite possibly to let them know that
did you ever,
he's okay.
Did you ever hear of white feathers appearing?
White feathers are supposed to be for angels, is the belief. If you have a white feather, an angel has visited you. That's what I've been told and believe. I believe in everything. It's not that I believe in it. I'm open to everything.
Yeah.
I'm open to... The more I've been in the paranormal world, the more I've been out investigating, talking to people, learning new things. You know, everything is possible, you know?
Yeah.
You have to have a certain degree of science behind everything. You have to be logical about everything, you know? Not take everything at face value. And once you have that unrepented bit of evidence to back up, so the spiritual and the scientific working together, it's a beautiful thing, like, you know.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. But it's very, you know, I've had experience with the white feathers myself, mm-hmm. and my sisters and, you know, my mother and that there. So, since my brother passed, you know. So, that's why I wanted to ask you that question.
Yeah.
You know, and one time these feathers appeared in underneath the car.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the car didn't move. It hadn't been moved. So, not unless a bird got down and got in underneath the car and flapped. But they were all, grouped up like that, you know.
How many white feathered birds do you see around Newry?
Well, this was in London.
In London.
The city.
Yeah.
Apart from that, so I remember the last time now you were on the Banter Show and you were telling me sometimes you get nipped when you're doing these paranormal investigations.
You can get nipped and get poked and you can get slapped. Yeah. What you'll find is in a haunted location, a lot of equipment failures. So
zapping the energy of the batteries and stuff.
Zapping the energy of the batteries. So the greatest energy you can bring into a location is laughter, happiness. And so actually your laughter and your good energy, the spirits will feed off it. They'll feed off your equipment, the batteries of your equipment. So the more energy a spirit has, the more activity you're going to have, obviously. Like, now you can't guarantee activity, like, but obviously the more energy that they can draw upon, the possibility of them giving off activity increases. So, like, I've been slapped, I've been poked, I've been, you know, nipped. Well,
that's serious, because see, on that note, you should be wearing something like this.
Hard hat, yeah.
And that's Kieran Hanna's hat of Hannah Oils up in Courtney Hill. Kieran, thanks for the donation for Mickey's Day as well. He donated £100 worth of home heating oil. Razor, Kieran, and if you want your hat, you know the old crack, you're going to have to come in for that bonder.
He's my oil man also.
He's got other great, good.
You can phone him any time, day or night, they're there. That's it.
Razor for the oil. Big time there. You know. I was good to say hello to Pat there the other day as well. So, it's the paranormal. It does exactly what it says in the bloody tin, doesn't it?
Well, the belief is, you know, it's paranormal. It's sort of like the Olympics and the Paralympics. It runs parallel with the normal. What is the normal like? But it's all around us, you know.
Yeah.
It's everywhere.
But can you tell me that right now? The footage I showed you of the ghost dog. Mm-hmm. Let's just call it the ghost dog for now.
The ghost dog. Yeah.
That was during the day.
Yeah.
Now, do you ever do investigations during the day, or do you go and maybe go on and survey a site and you actually see or hear something during the day, you know?
I would do most of my meetings during the day on a location, obviously, because you can photograph it. You can look around better in the daylight. Now, it's the great myth that spirits are only active in the darkness.
That's what I was getting to.
Now, some of the photographic equipment, the full spectrum cameras, the night vision cameras, they're designed to work in darkness, you know, so hence you'd use those for capturing evidence at night. But like, I've been in the Tain Holiday Village, St. Michael's, during the day. You have children laughing, crying, doors banging, slamming, you know, so it doesn't matter day or night, you know.
And that's live, that goes on when you're down in the place during the day, and doors banging.
As I say, the children laughing. Now, we do have the O'Meath to Carnford Greenway run alongside us.
Yes.
I thought there's profound laughing and giggling and cracking going on down in the lower levels in one of the oldest parts of the building. And I goes, Jesus, somebody's broken off the... But we couldn't find anybody. I mean, we'd hear it on up towards the swimming pool. And as I would, anywhere I would go where I was hearing the laughing, it wasn't there, you know, so... I said to myself, here, it's time to go topside, you know what I mean? Sometimes when you're not looking for it, it's there, you know?
Have you got a big frightener yet, Sean? Have you got really frightened at any stage? Because you're at this a long time now.
I'm at this a long time. I don't get frightened. I maybe get surprised.
Startled.
I get startled if I'm not... Well, it's not that I get surprised, you know?
Because you're investigating, so the slightest noise or... Whatever, you're going to be switched on for it, aren't you?
You're switched on for everything. We'll have, we have live feed mics now. That the belief is, you've heard of the electronic voice phenomenon, where you have your EVP recorders, which are basically sound recorders, the Zooms that you can use in the jam. In fact, if you wanted to record, but we actually, the belief is that the spirits are communicating at a different frequency that we can't pick up audibly, but the sound recorders can. But we've actually got live feed mics now with a few seconds delay that you can hear the spirits live, unplugged, you know. So we've had a lot of that going on. It means if you can hear a spirit replying to you live, it means you can have a conversation with them. Whereas if you're recording it, you're going home to review it, and you know, so you, it means that if you're having communication with a spirit with a recorder, you're asking questions for specific answers. But if you're having it live in your ear, you can have a good conversation. You know,
that makes a lot of sense.
You know what I mean? So
that does make sense.
If it makes sense to other people, but if you're having a conversation live, it's like somebody sending you a letter. You have to read that letter, and then you have to go back and send them a letter and wait for that letter. Whereas you have the internet, it's just like the internet now. You can speak live. Hopefully, you know, we do get a lot of once we're working as a team, we'll have say Gareth Coburn there from Carnforth and the wife Laura, and Gareth, we would call him our ghost magnet, and he has a spirit guide too. We're big into the shamanics with this group, and he would listen live. So you've always got somebody monitoring the whole situation. So he could be listening live, but we'd be using a planchette, and somebody's going to be recording it on a full spectrum camera or a night vision camera. Somebody's taking photographs on a full spectrum camera. Then you'll have Angela Morda and Geraldine there. They'll be there doing the planchettes. And then but Gordon Rowland, he's a great man for the full spectrum photography. So we've got sort of everybody has just fallen into place then, you know.
Everybody's a role then.
Everybody's sort of nobody was assigned roles, but everybody's taking these roles in. There's my fiance Colleen there, she would come with us too. And you have a friend of mine, Joanna has been with me from the start of my paranormal, well, not my paranormal journey, but my public paranormal journey. I've always been interested in, I've always been doing little investigations and ghost walks and graveyard. But when I started doing publicly there maybe a few years back, I met Joanna at the start, and we'd parted ways, not anything bad, like, but just life took different paths for a while. And I formed Nocturnal NEWRY for a while, and I sort of went out on a limb and asked her, would you like to come on board? So we're all delighted. So we're one big happy family, and as I say, all the partners are involved. So it's a good family friendly positive atmosphere, and you'll find positivity promotes positivity.
Indeed.
So everybody's just fallen into a role. You know, we don't arrive on site and say, right, you're doing this, you're doing that. You know, over the period of the year or so that we're together, everybody's just found their own niche, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Gareth's great with the spirits, Gordon's great with the photography, Angela and Geraldine McGuire, they're great with people and the communications with the spirits. Lynn would be Gordon's wife, she's great with the public too, and keeping an ear for live, you know, knocks, bangs. Laura is brilliant with public, so everybody has their role. Colleen's brilliant with public too, so
she's all brilliant, basically.
Everybody's brilliant, right? Riser to the Nocturnal NEWRY.
Riser to the Nocturnal NEWRY.
So that's basically what Nocturnal NEWRY is about. Having fun. Obviously, it's an event business. Paranormal investigation's not cheap. It's not cheap. The equipment's very expensive, but as I say, we try and do it old school.
Yeah.
We like to have that connection with the spirit rather than seeing it through videos or things. We have all the equipment that we need and all the meters, but it's great getting up front and personal with it, you know?
Yeah.
So that's our ethos in that. So that's just one of the things that Nocturnal NEWRY do. We do these public events, obviously, but we'll travel the country as a team. The NNPI, Nocturnal NEWRY Paranormal Investigators or Investigations, that's my events team there that I just spoke about. Those are the guys who come on the events and run the events, and they're all fantastic with public. But Nocturnal NEWRY then, it would be the parent company. Now, we hosted another team down in our location there on Saturday night. I'll give a shout out to the Shadow Hunters.
Razor.
Shadow Hunters NI. They do the events up in the Crumlin Road Jail. And they had two celebrities over there at the weekend. So they done an investigation in the Crumlin Road Jail on the Friday night. And we hosted them down in St. Michael's then on the Saturday night. So we had Ray Jordan from Haunting Australia. We had a Samantha Carter then from ITV's Paranormal 5. and just lovely people, you know what I mean?
And funny, Ray Jordan, and because I know Ray Jordan from Twitter, and Ian Lawman, Razor, Ian's away out to Australia.
Yeah, yeah. So
that's a good one.
Yeah, they're good people. Obviously, sometimes they tell you don't meet their heroes, you might be let down, but I've been following these guys for a long time, and they're just like one of the boys, like, you know,
they're down to earth.
And what we like to have, we like when we're doing an investigation, we like to gather evidence, but we like to have fun. You know, it's the ethos of fun, and you'll find the more fun and more enjoyment you're having, the more you're gonna get. You know, more positive vibes. But yeah, Ray, we hit it off with them straight away. All the team hit it off with them. So that was our first celebrity event with the Shadow Hunters, and it was good. It was good to tie a wee one in, because some of the people that went on the Friday night to the Cumann na mBuail jail came down the whole way to St Michael's Inn on the Saturday night, and it was good to tie in the fact that Eamon De Valera used to hide out in St Michael's.
There you go.
There's an exclusive there for you. They used to dress him as a priest.
God knows what went on there. we're not going into that one.
That's for a different story. Right, that's a different night.
Well, that's a different investigation altogether.
The old IRA used to hide out down there at times of the Troubles, especially 1915. There was an ambush. The British Army ambushed the guys up there at the Egyptian Arches. There's a plaque for them. And at those times, you couldn't have been brought to the hospital for IRA. You were goosed. So they used to seek solitude down in St. Michael's. And when the British Army would come down to get them, they'd be hidden out at sea. They'd be under the water. Now, whether they had the reed pipes like James Bond or whatever, we don't know. But even Eamon De Valera, he was one of the famous guys who would have hid out there, and he would have been seen by the locals, knew who he was, but wouldn't say nothing. But they would have been coming out of the old house and heading down, and he would have been doing the daily routine of milking the cattle and all, but he would have hid out there. Now, the connection was that he was the leader of the anti-3D party at the time, but before the partition of Ireland, he was elected as the representative for Down. So that's when he was arrested that time at Newry Town Hall. I think it was 1923. But they put him Dublin bound on the train and told him never to come across the border again. They took him to Canal Street Barracks that time. But he was having none of it. I think it was 3 days later he was arrested up in St. Columbus College, up in Derry, or Londonderry, Dwyer, whatever. And he spent a few months in the Cumann na mBuail jail. So I could link the two. I know it was a tedious link, but I could link the two on the
That's
night,
unreal.
You know.
That's unreal.
So, you know, just things like that, people aren't aware of their history.
So it's a very historical site.
It's a very historical site. It dates back to the 1800s. It was a private residence for William Greer. If you've heard of Greer's Quay down there, that would have been named after William Greer. Now, briefly, William Greer was a Dublin solicitor, or barrister, and he was a Reverend William Greer, Presbyterian minister. So you had the Presbyterians in, and then you had the Rusminian order then in after that. And then the last form of the build was the Town Hall Lay Village, and so there's a lot more to it. People just see the Hall Lay Village, but there's a lot of history to that building, you know. And we're trying to preserve what we have left of St. Michael's, what being the school itself, built by the Rusminians in 1908. So we're trying to preserve what we have there, and hopefully open it up for other things rather than ghost hunting. I'm great into the Irish language. I'm trying my best to learn. Now, I'm in Bunrang at the minute, but it would be great for an old Gaelic ras like St. Michael's to have candlelit Irish nights and Irish classes.
Mm.
That's what I'm trying to look into.
Although they've got the Gaelic ras McCardle up in Chapel Street, so that's
they have the Gaelic ras up there.
The new flagship.
I do Monday nights up there. I do Wednesday nights down in Cornamuckla House. My Saoirse comes up from from Belfast, from the culture land, and but it'd be nice for the Ethiopians,
all the Ethiopians. You could maybe try it down at
the Grandview Hotel,
because it's the hot spot in Omeath.
Big
shout out to everybody. Thanks for all the juices and crisps and everything for Mickey's Day, by the way.
It would just be nice for, I would invite all the Irish speakers around the place, just for an evening of, you know, back to the old classrooms, the candle, the toilet, and have a, you know, just wee Irish night Unplugged Irish night.
Unplugged Irish. I must unplugged actually start Irish brushing night. Up on the Irish again, because
I let it lapse there. We want to use it for other uses, obviously. A lot of people think that, oh, you're doing ghost hunting there, you know, it's a dark thing, you're devil worshipping, but we want to show people that it's not. I opened it up to photographers as well. You have, you know, these people into the urban, exploring the urbex. Any photographers will want to take photographs, they'll take them in and show them around, and you have a lot of wildlife then to the shore, and that, you know, so there's a lot going on there.
It's a very scenic area.
It's beautiful.
This whole area really is very scenic, isn't it? Yeah. Flagstaff and all looking down towards the
Newry was almost part of the south in the partition, but then they realised that Newry Shipping Canal and its economic viability, that they had to take that back. So we could have been here speaking Irish now.
And it had the first inland shipping canal.
It was the first
in the British, the first
summit level shipping canal, and I'm so glad now that I come across this in the Newry history tours, that maybe telling people about the shipping canal, but I'm so glad that up towards Points Pass that they're regenerating it, and I'm hoping in the future then we can have boats come in from sea and go the whole way up to.
It'd be lovely, wouldn't it?
Wouldn't it just be beautiful?
Fantastic.
If you go to Manchester, Liverpool, any of these canals,
even London,
you can go, you know, all around.
Regent's Canal's all opened up. You know, Graham Farmworth, he was asking, Razor Graham, I hope you got somebody to go boating with you today. Oh, there you go. This very day, the Regent's Canal in London. You
know, so it'd be nice if that was opened up. But the Victoria Lock Gates, obviously named after Queen Victoria and the Albert Basin, well, they were great into the yachting, and they would have been down Strabbering that a lot. And they're very fond of Irish whiskey brewed in Newry by Henry Thompson's, Mercer Henry Thompson's and Co.
That was quite a tag.
And
His rum would have been good too.
His rum was fine stuff.
All around the world.
But they supplied both the Houses of Commons, and Queen Victoria and Albert loved it. And that's where the parochial hall was then. That was being Henry Thompson Co's warehouse. So that's where they stored all the whiskey and that, you know. And later sold on to the Catholic Church. So that's just a wee bit about the shipping canal, like, you know. Mm. It was involved in the slave trade indirectly too. The English ports took a lottery basically on the direct trade of slaves, but that didn't mean that the Irish ports couldn't profit from it by supplying. So you had boats coming up the canal full of sugar from St. Bart's and St. Kitts up to Sugar Island, to the merchant.
From the West Indies?
From the West Indies, the whole way over up Sugar Island. And then they would have got loaded with timber and cattle and beef and wood, and, you know, direct trading with the slave plantation. So there's a wee bit of a darker side to the canal as well.
Yeah.
But it's just it's
Newry. That's the way things were. Yeah. Everything, you know, wasn't regulated right and all this.
Newry was on the map before Belfast was even thought of.
Like, that's right, yeah.
But that's just another thing. And then under the branch then of Nocturnal Newry, with we launched the Newry Murder Mystery Club about almost a year ago as well. I write the original scripts for the murder mysteries, but we do it multimedia instead of handing out wee envelopes of evidence. Of young Darren McCahey from Innovations Media, he does the videos, and we have the videos and sound effects and everything going. Now the first one we done was the murder of Lord Baskerville. Comedy farce, brilliant, brilliant crack to all involved. But this one, now on a more serious note, the one we're doing now is the murder of Caffrey Rennie. I don't know if I can say it on a serious note, but it's set to a theme of Hello, Hello.
Perfect.
And it's another comedy farce as well. But we've roped in Cara Fearn and the Burness Bells. Razor
Cara. And I was acting with Cara recently for Judith Murphy's short movie coming up. Yeah. Brilliant crack. So, good girl.
I had seen Cara about, and I says, wouldn't this be great to, because it's set in Paris, it's set in the cafe.
That's perfect.
Couldn't we just have like a burlesque sort of Moulin Rouge type of. So that was it. My idea was to have Cara and the girls do a burlesque performance, but I ended up, I have the girls acting in it. So we have a lot of eye candy now in it for all the guys out there. There's a lot of eye candy in it. So it's comedy, eye candy, and food. Cara's taken apart. Our daughter Cochlin's taken apart. Another one of the girls, Kira's taken apart. So, and I have a big fella, I have Gareth from the Nocturnal NEWRY team. He's taking the part of Rene. He's fucking hilarious. Sorry.
Don't be sorry, it's the Banter Show.
It's the Banter Show. But he's a pure scream. But it's all made of the Southern Area Hospice.
Good. Good ball.
It's all in the Southern Area Hospice. I'll just give a shout out to David Downey and Anne over in the bank. Cause
Razor David and Anne.
They can't do enough for us.
Yeah.
You know, they can't, honestly, even as far as rehearsal space, they're giving us everything, you know. So on the night, the tickets are £20. They are available now from the bank bar. But with that, you get your murder mystery, the whole murder mystery night. You get your burlesque show in the middle of it. There's a raffle. And then
it's probably worth 30 quid, the burlesque show.
Burlesque show, yeah.
Maybe a crack well as a razor.
Razor. I've saved you a few razors.
A lot of razors. That's really the courage.
So,
behave.
Your supper's all included, full buffet. And then young Neil Heaney, he's doing the disco and all of it. So I think we're the only murder mystery. We're the only murder mystery night that we have actors from the Games of Thrones in it.
That's right. That's true. That's Neil was in it, not yeah.
Neil's
great lad. Razor Neil and Eddie and all the Heaneys.
All the Heaneys.
Garrett, the whole lot of them. Polly. Brilliant family.
Eddie's done a good job with them boys. They're all class fellas.
They're lovely family. Yeah. They really are. They're top notch family.
I used to play pool with them and all, but I still go away on the pool day weekends, and we just have a ball, like, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I bet this is Jakob from Poland, and he's going to come in through the door again.
Yeah.
It's just part of the old Banter Show.
Come in, Banter. Come on in. Come on.
So you're very busy then, Sean. Well, you're busy apart from your day job.
My day job, yeah.
And then you come home, and away you go again.
I come home, I'd be running the meetings. I'd be spending a lot of time behind the computer. I'd be writing because I have Anthony Fitzpatrick on board too. But obviously, when we have the Murder Mystery Club, you have to have scripts to back it up. So I've been writing scripts now for a year. So we actually have three scripts that we can use. We're writing one specifically then for next Halloween. I'm working on next Halloween now. It'll be the Lady in Black murder mystery. It's a wee bit darker for Halloween. We're going to be doing Pink Panther murder mystery.
The Pink Panther gets murdered.
Pink Panther murder mystery. The return of the Pink Panther murder mystery. We have the Murder Lord Baskerville has been asked to come back up, and the club has been asked to go on the road basically all over Ireland. A few people have picked up on the Murder Cafe Rennie and want us to take it on the road basically, like, so everything just seems to be something else we're rolling into something else, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But we wouldn't have it any other way.
Well done, you're keeping yourself flat out.
I'm trying to get married too this year. I'm getting married at Christmas. So
at
Christmas, the 30th of December.
Wow.
Getting married in the Constance Hall.
Lovely. Oh,
getting
great spot.
The Constance Hall, so I'm trying to organise all that in between as well. It's non-stop, like, you know.
Look, I love the cost out there.
I wouldn't have it any other
way. I love the sun. I love getting the solar panel charged up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Well, that's amazing. Yeah. See, you're keeping really busy.
We're keeping busy. We're keeping it real. And, you know, I suppose I'm living in Newry from... I'm born and bred in Barca. I'm living in Newry over 30 years now. We just wanted to be doing something else at the weekend rather than going to the pub. So
I hear you.
The paranormal events was one thing. We take people down to Dublin Hellfire Club as well. But we want to offer other things. We're doing a singles night now. SpookyDating.com.
Are you serious?
God,
a singles night for spooky daters.
Only here. Exclusive.
Exclusive. Couple of exclusives here tonight, friends.
We're doing hauntedhens.com and haunted hen parties.
You need to hear what's all that.
But
soundproof the whole area.
Our philosophy, we just don't talk about the most haunted places in Ireland. We take you there, but Rob's asking people what do you want us to do? Obviously, we know what people want, but unless you ask people what they want, you never know, like, you know. So
yeah,
those two things have come out of it. There's a lot, like I've been in the paranormal publicly for a while now. You
you do find a lot of singles. You do find a lot of people meeting people at different public events. And
why not meet somebody at a paranormal event? You know, when you marry them.
Jump into their arms when you get a fright. It's a starter, you know.
That's what you're playing at. Well, that brings it to you. And they'll be doing a lot of Lisbon Barna next.
Lisbon Barna.
the matchmaking festival.
The Bliss Festival down in there.
Oh, Nurra Water, yeah. Yeah. That's unbelievable. Look at you. I'll check that one. We'll do an investigation at that one, me and you. Right?
Yeah.
We'll do our own investigation.
Banter Show live from the Bliss Festival.
Tell you, we could do a Banter Show from the Bliss Festival.
Banter from the Bliss.
Well, listen, anybody you want to give a shout out to before we wrap this up?
I'll give a shout out to all the Nocturnal NEWRY team.
Right.
You know all who you are. You're all going to be seeing it. And thanks for being wonderful and supporting us the whole way here. And the Burlesque Bells, Anthony Fitzpatrick, and the whole NEWRY Murder Mystery Club crew.
There you go. Not only that, special shout out to Jerry Mackey, Razor Jerry.
Jerry,
Razor. Paul, Razor Jerry, keep her strong, keep yourself right there.
And the old fella Paul.
Paul Mackey, I'm down over in the Liverpool.
Over Weston Merseyside.
Oh, Weston Merseyside.
Yes. I got the train there to Roper's Bridge.
Oh, and the deeper brother Keenan in Liverpool. Razor Arsenal.
Yeah, Smith Razor.
Yeah. So that's but another. You've
another interesting.
I've learned, and every time you come in,
so.
I've learned.
I hope you've learned and I haven't trained you.
No. I'm always up for the air bomber.
It's almost
you should know that by now, Sean.
Up for the crack.
Yeah, you should know that by now. But listen, always good, brother.
Thanks
always
very
good.
Much for having us on.
Not a bother.
I hope I haven't missed anybody out, but I think I've mentioned everybody there.
I think we've mentioned there. Everybody, thanks for tuning into the Banter Show. And it's great to hear this man, local man, coming in and giving us all his time and his effort. Tell us about your efforts. You know, this is the beauty of the Banter Show. So if you want to promote what you're doing, same as this man here.
Exactly, come on the Banter Show.
If you want to promote your event, come in, talk to us here, sit down on the couch, and let's have a bit of banter.
Whether it be charities or events or whatever you're doing, come into the Banter Show. I highly recommend it.
Good man, Sean. Yeah. Get yourself ready. You know, your crack friends, from me and Sean Donegan, we're out of here. Right here.